We're now at a 15.5 PE on the S&P 500 with fantastic cash flow earnings. Names are coming out of the woodwork with above expectation cash flows. Maybe what happens here is it's an opportunity to park your cash in places where companies are cash flowing, paying dividends, and market stays flat for the rest of the year while it tries to assimilate the risks, the interest rate stuff, the political stuff. But this is an inexpensive market with great earnings. So I'm not that worried about it. I'm still staying true to the course on equities, but I'm changing the tone of my holdings to my favorite topic, cash flow. Love cash flow. You're not getting rewarded to go into the high-risk names anymore. Tesla and that kind of stuff.
Yep, the high-growth tech names.
You know, they don't have any cash flow, and I think that's going to become the new theme. And that's what I think matters now. People are going to say, I want some quality in my portfolio.
It's this comment, Jim, from the Caterpillar CFO using the words high watermark, talking about their profits, that seem to have everybody falling out of bed yesterday. The market goes down 400 points. Maybe it's the 3% deal on the 10-year that piles onto that. But it is the debate as to whether we're in the process of peaking, whether earnings are peaking, and whether that means the stock market and this bull market is about to reach its peak as well.
Yeah, and certainly, look, the growth rate that we're seeing in earnings in the first quarter is not expected to continue throughout the rest of the year or into 2019, but earnings are expected to grow. I think Caterpillar is a great example on many fronts, Scott. On one front, just to begin with, this is another company that had a blowout earnings number and was absolutely slaughtered, just like Twitter today, just like Goldman Sachs last week. And what it's really telling me is that, look, any way you cut those numbers, they were good numbers. They raised their guidance by more for the full year, more than the beat yesterday. I don't want to go on and on about Cat. What I want to say is,
if we get into a sell on the news type of market,
where
earnings are really good and people are selling the stocks down, that's not a good environment for the bulls.
You're right. It's not good in the short term. Okay, because what it means is people are taking profits and they're clearly not putting that money back to work into the markets. They're scared. What are they scared of? All the things we know: tariffs, perhaps an economic slowdown, etc. But frankly, the economic data, and this is a little bit of what Kevin was saying, is not showing any signs of a near-term recession. So it's just a matter of investors getting patient again to put their money to work in stocks that are now a heck of a lot cheaper than they were 2 months ago.
All right, Pete, how do you see it?
You know, I think the breakdown for me comes down to the algorithms that are still in this marketplace, and let's not deny that they're there. And when we hit 3%, I think that was the trigger yesterday, as much as what we heard from the Cat CFO. I mean, where was Caterpillar before that? Caterpillar had a pretty strong start to the day, right? I mean, it was up significantly and then started this sell-off.
Caterpillar didn't go down 6% because of the 3% on the 10-year.
No, okay? Probably not. But then all of a sudden, the rest of the algorithms come into play, right? I mean, I'm a true believer.
Are you really dismissing these comments from? I mean,
I'm not dismissing
them. They say something's a high watermark of earnings.
I'm not dismissing.
That's not concerning.
I'm not dismissing them. It would be concerning if every single one of the CFOs came out and said that. I look at this differently, and Kevin points out 15.5 on the S&P. That seems pretty good. Cash flows are strong. That seems pretty good. Economic conditions are very strong still. That seems pretty good. So I think what you're seeing right now is people have to get comfortable with 3%. They've been told and brainwashed into the idea, hey, we hit 3%. Let's start getting out of these stocks. And I think once we digest some of that, Scott, I think we'll start to see the market go
back. Ian, just a day ago, you know, people were talking about Caterpillar as a bellwether of global growth. If Caterpillar's calling peak,
it's a problem.
That's not what they called, though, but I'll get to after
they
Brent.
Said peak quarter.
They're talking about peak profits per share, or they said high watermark.
High watermark, which means high watermark.
Doesn't that
means
is
the
as
highest
good as
it's
it gets?
Been. No, it doesn't. And that's not what Brad Halverson said. He said, just as you say, when you clarified, high watermark. Now, that is not the same as saying this is as good as it gets.
Also,
it's just saying this is as high as the water's risen to this point. You know who does this all the time? Elon Musk. High watermark for number of cars delivered and so forth. And it's higher and higher and higher.
You see the high watermark during a flood after it subsides, and you see the mark on the wall.
Yeah, but
so
that's the question.
Earnings are there at the top, and it's going to start coming down. The market's going to come down with it.
Are we back to the Fed speak, Scott, where you have to kind of parse, what did Greenspan really mean when he said high watermark? Did he really mean that that's as good as it gets, Jack Nicholson? Or did he really mean, well, that's just on its way to a much higher level over the next several quarters?
Hey, Scott, so a couple things. We talk about free cash flow, but let's talk about how they're spending it. Okay, what did Caterpillar say? They're going to start some CapEx. What did Google say? We're going to start some CapEx. All of a sudden, market doesn't like them spending their free cash flow like that. They want buybacks. And as far as 3%, for people to say the bulls who've been hanging on for years about this, there is no alternative argument because of where rates are, all of a sudden, rates, the difference between the earnings yield on the S&P 500 and the 10-year rate are the lowest it's been since 2008. To say that that doesn't matter, to me, is just not being intellectually honest. There are alternatives now, and we just have to realize that's why the multiple's contracting a little bit.
Want to debate that?
CapEx, the reason that's occurring, and let's remember what happened in the tax code, you are now incentivized to CapEx your way as much as you can because you're writing that off in an accelerated period. So if you're ever going to spend dollars in America, you're going to do it now, whether you're small, mid-cap, or small. So I don't like to think that CapEx is a good metric of anything versus earnings, because these CapEx expenditures are going to flower and come forth with more cash flow. That's why they're being expended. And we've told these companies to do that. We said repatriate and spend.
And who's it going to flow through to? Caterpillar, which now, to your point earlier, the market at 15.5 times earnings, Caterpillar's now at 13.5 times earning because they raised their guidance for this year by 20%.
Yeah, but Caterpillar's a cyclical. And cyclicals
just
always
one
look
name,
cheap.
It's
no,
just
I know,
one
but
name.
Cyclicals always look cheap at the top, and they always look expensive at the bottom. Now, if you think there's a secular story going on, you're absolutely right.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.